Good morning. Welcome to CVR English Business Life. So we are almost at the doors of the weekend. So this is the last day of this week. Of course, it was a truncated week, you know, had a holiday yesterday and great festival was celebrated across India. So back to business. So coming down to the Dow Jones closing as on yesterday in the US markets, after the Federal Reserve announcement, there was positivity indicated and the index closed at about 216 points gains. And the NASDAQ also gave a close in positive range, but it was very flattish. That's about 1.5 point positive. And coming down to the Asian market, starting with the Nikkei, Nikkei is trading with about minus 45 points right now. Hang Seng is trading minus 200. The Shanghai index is also fallen by about 30 points. SGX Nifty is trading with minus 20 points. So we could call it as a sea of red kind of scenario right now in the Asian markets. That's about 11,573 is the SGX Nifty trading today. And if we look into the last week's market statistics, that's the declines and advancings were about, in the Nifty 50, if we take a look, the advances were about 16 stocks and the declines 34. In BSE 200, the advances was 71 and the declines were about 129. And there was one stock which was remaining as unchanged. Now coming to the Nifty 50 top five gainers, India Bulls Housing Finance, Hindalco, Infosys, Dr. Reddy, and L&T were the gainers between 2% to 5%. And the top five losers were about Hindustan Petroleum, Zeal, Bharat Petroleum, NTPC, and ONGC lost ground about 3% to 6% in the whole of the day as on Wednesday. So now, getting the kind of negative cues starting with Wednesday onwards, the markets have slightly, you know, converted their advances into, you know, declines favor. So will this be the continuation mode even on, you know, Friday? Because normally every Friday, you know, we have a weekly closing happening, especially a lot of experts take a closer look on the weekend behavior of the market. So I welcome my guest, Mr. Chirag, the analyst, would guide us further into the markets. So hi, Chirag.
Hi, good morning. Good morning.
Very good morning. So what do you feel like, you know, markets have been giving slight amount of kind of correction, you know, getting into that kind of mode on Wednesday itself. So will they get aggravated today?
Well, if you look at the overall chart structure of Nifty, we have rallied from a low of around 10,585 to a recent high of somewhere around 11,556. So that's a good 1,000 point rally in itself. And we've not seen any, you know, reasonable correction that has come through in the market. So any kind of a profit taking move towards even say 11,200 should be used as a buying opportunity is what we are recommending. And having said that, you can go long on the Nifty today, buy around 10,550, stop loss will be 10,450, upside targets can be 10,650, 10,700.
Okay, so what are the kind of you know, indications looking going into trade, Chirag? As on today, can there be any kind of a further selling aggravation in the OMCs? Because starting from the day one of March series, we have been seeing, you know, the oil marketing companies, especially the Hindustan Petroleum, you know, and the Bharat Petroleum. Along with that, IOC also you know, declared a dividend, but the stocks, you know, went into a good correction mode starting from Wednesday onward on the 20th of March. So will that get further you know, into a short mode, or one can find a short opportunity, or better book your profits if you are long and then exit?
Well, if you're long and you're still holding on to the stock, I would recommend you to exit, at least as far as all these OMCs are concerned. Hind Petro, to be specific, has closed at its lowest trading you know, level in more than three sessions. And this is clearly indicating that you know, a lot of selling may continue if the stock breaks below 273 on the downside. Having said this, the stock has also witnessed a lot of sell-off from higher levels. That is, a short build-up was seen in the stock. So avoid going long in this counter, at least for the day. Let us see as to how it behaves for the next couple of sessions, and then you can decide as to where it has to be gone to.
Okay. Now, looking into the other aspects of the market, what we have been seeing is especially the FIIs, you know, still they remained as strong buyers, net buyers in the market. The FII figures, if we take a look into the 18th of March, that's about 1,823 crores were buyers. And on the 19th of March, the FIIs were again buyers to the tune of 2,132 crores. And the 20th of March, that was on the Wednesday, they again were, you know, buyers to the tune of about 1,772 crores. Coming to the DIIs, DIIs were again sellers for all the 3 days, starting from the 18th to the 20th of March, by 1,200 crores on the 18th of March, 19th, 1,254 crores, and the 20th again, 1,323 crores. So these kind of sellings is being continuously, you know, being checked into the DIIs, and they were never one single day, even for one single day, they were never buyers in the month of March. But there were 20,000 plus crores being invested by the FIIs. There's huge amount of dollar inflow into the market. So, you know, kind of indications are positive right now, but markets are looking slightly onto the fatigue, you know, in getting into a profit booking zone. So let's check with my other guest, Mr. Ajayji, who is also going to guide us into the markets right now. So what do you feel, Ajayji, coming down to the last day of this week? Book profits or buy more?
First of all, happy Holi to you, and Chirag, happy Holi.
Thank you.
Yeah, market, I would expect huge intraday dips once in a way, which will be bought. And for those who don't even look at the market on a daily basis, they would not, they would think that nothing has changed. So a lot may go on intraday, but it will not reflect at the end of the day, is my personal take, because the corrections which are going on are very shallow. DIIs are continuously selling, FIIs are continuously buying. Let that change. Then maybe we will see that the good breather in the market should come closer to election. Right now, I don't think anything of that sort is going to happen. We may have shallow corrections.
Okay. So, what do you feel these stocks which you have been, you know, very bullish on to? So, is this the time to take some profits, and because the correction can also, you know, starting from today, whether the correction is deeper in the index, Ajayji, or not, but the stocks, you know, stock specific might be getting into correction. Which are the ones you recommend, you know, they have gone very high and, you know, they can be booked at this point of time? Reliance, you have...
The FMCG, I think one need not be in a hurry to book out of them. But Bata, yes, one has to be very careful. It has run up too fast. So if you're having Bata, HDFC Bank, Axis Bank, Kotak Bank, Kotak not yet, it's just broken out of a range. One has to be careful, United Phosphorus. I think it's not a bad idea to take 25% off.
Okay, so Ajayji,
it may be wrong, but it's okay.
Okay, so Ajayji, which sector do you feel is going to, you know, get into a deeper correction to start with as of today? Would that be oil marketing companies or the FMCGs or what?
Sir, the non-performers will get worse hit. If oil goes up, although the rupee is tending to get stronger, that's a negative for oil marketing companies. But yesterday, day before, you saw the move which Interglobe Aviation made. Where is the oil over there? So, it's just the market sentiment. It's very difficult to predict. But it's good to take some profit off now. Having said that, there are plenty of buys even now.
Which are the ones? Can we know one name?
Yeah, I had last time said that these engineering sector, by the way, L&T, there was a misunderstanding. I never said L&T is not a good buy. I said L&T is a buy on a decline. So like L&T, BHEL, Siemens, ABB, all these guys are good on declines. For now, it is BHEL, and there's a stock in the realty sector which has not participated. I think it should start soon. Sobha, it's a good stock with good results. So, United Spirits can be looked into. Pidilite, there are some IT shares, Tata Elxsi. There's a IT stock called Take Solutions. It has fallen from 300 to 120. I think it's a good punt. The risk reward is very good. And HDFC life insurance also last time I had recommended. That's the basket.
Okay. So now let's very importantly look into the other stocks. Before that, we would like to give you the updates about the corporate actions here. Now, let's look into the other corporate action, that is Coal India, NMDC, and we have the dividends being, you know, getting announced by these companies and the board meetings by Aarti Industry, EID Parry, and SBI as well. So coming to you, Chirag, which, you know, SBI is going to have a board meeting today. So will that be any impact on the stock, or can anybody, you know, look into the SBI for technical reasons?
Well, I think we should not speculate about what is going to happen in the board meetings, and we should stick to technicals. Technically, well, it is looking like the, you know, the stock is likely to move towards 310 over the next 4 to 5 trading sessions if the positivity in the market continues. And if you look at the overall you know, movement of the Bank Nifty, though SBI has not got a lot of weight in it, it is a clear favorite as far as the you know, the PSU bank space is concerned. So SBI looks well set for upside targets of 310, but it has resistance around 306-307. So if that zone is crossed, then of course 310-315 can be seen over the next 4 to 5 trading sessions in State Bank of India.
Okay, so we have a couple of stocks, Chirag, which are, you know, having kind of strong delivery percentages, and these were also being asked by a couple of viewers who have sent us the mail. So Mr. Somesh has sent us a stock mail called, you know, Castrol Industries. He's been holding this stock about 170 and 180 zones. So what could be the future of this stock, and, you know, can we recommend them, can you recommend them to stay invested or book there or exit there from their stock?
Well, if you look at, you know, the technical chart pattern of Castrol India, I mean, it is in a no trade zone for the time being. The simple reason being that it is facing a lot of resistance around 170, 175, exactly where Mr. Somesh has, you know, purchased that stock. And it has witnessed a sharp correction towards 156. So what I would recommend him is that he can go long in this stock, at least for the time being, to average it, and then hold it with a stop loss place below, say, 130. This would be a positional trade, but not a short to medium term trade. And for long term investment, of course, it is a buy. The company enjoys a lot of good fundamentals, so you should definitely have this in your portfolio for long term.
So any stocks would you like to recommend to go long or short, Chirag, as on today?
Yes, I have a few stocks as far as an intraday trade is concerned. You can look at DLF. DLF is looking very good on charts. It is currently trading around 199. So 198 is where you go long in this counter. And owing to the high beta nature of the stock, we recommend you to place a stop loss below 192. Though it is a far off stop loss, but it is necessary for a stock like DLF. Upside targets can be 205 to 207. MFSL is another stock which is looking good. 457 is where you go long on declines, and 443 will be the stop on the downside. Upside targets can be 478. The other one is India Bulls Housing Finance. It was one of the top gainers in the Nifty pack the other day, I mean on Wednesday. And 730 is where you go long. 708 is the stop loss on the downside. Upside targets can be 763. Now coming to the stocks on the short side, for the day I would recommend you to go short on Maruti if it sustains below 6640 levels, and you know, the downside targets can be 6300, 6340. That is where you know, you will see a lot of value buying coming through, but you know, that kind of a level on the downside is very much possible in Maruti. The other one is Tata Steel. Tata Steel has been witnessing a lot of selling pressure over the last few sessions, and it is clearly indicating that the stock is likely to move towards, you know, 480, 485 on the downside. It is going to retrace the up move that it was giving over the past few sessions. So go short on Tata Steel. Stop loss will be 525 on the upside.
Okay. So next week, we are going to see the, Chirag, the, you know, kind of derivatives expiry week. So starting from today, we have 4 more days in the next week to go, and today is the first, you know, starting from the first day, the countdown begins for the next 5 days of expiry. So March series, you know, what do you feel, you know, to start with, any stocks can be taken for the new series of April month, or any kind of shorts can be preferred in the index or stock futures or something? Do you see any kind of an opportunity?
Well, I think it's too early to speak about, you know, what to roll over and what not to. At least from the current perspective, what you can look at is rolling over positions in stocks which have seen a lot of long built up throughout the series. and these are the stocks which are going to be outperformers over the next next series or so. On the other hand, stocks which have witnessed a lot of short built up or long unwindings can be looked as a shorting opportunity and can be entered into a short trade, and your positions can be rolled over into the next series.
Okay, so viewers, the markets have opened right now, and let's look into the Nifty 50 index that's trading at about 25 points higher, 11,546. And the top gainers we look at, and that is India Bulls Housing Finance, which is up by about 1.5%, trading at about 743. NTPC is up by 1.3%, and that's trading at about 131. Bharti Airtel is also up by 1%, trading at 337. Zeal, which was again a loser as on 20th of March today, it's gaining about 1%, that's trading at 447. And we have few losers as well in the Nifty 50 index. That's Maruti is the top loser by about 1.2%. 6,597 is where it is trading currently at. Hindustan Petroleum losing by about 0.7%, trading at 273. TCS coming up, trading at about 0.5% losses. That's 2006. VEDL is losing ground about 0.4%. ONGC is again one of the top losers in the top six. And Hindalco, UPL, Adani Ports are all on the losing ground. So Ajayji, looking at the these kind of profit booking as Maruti, does it look at mouth-watering levels, or do you feel the correction is still on?
Chirag very rightly said that Maruti
can be shorted. This is the time to start accumulating Maruti. See, one can never time the market. So, around 6.4, 6.5, a little higher than what the levels the chartist will give, is the time to buy it off.
Okay. So, we have a couple of stocks in the mid-caps, in the Nifty Next 50. The Siemens is getting into a profit booking area wherein the stock has fallen by about 0.6%. So Siemens is what you have been closely looking at. So what do you feel like Siemens? Is it a good opportunity to buy or book profits and exit?
Sir, there is never a harm in booking profits if you have it. So Siemens is on below, let's say around 1025, 1040, it's a very good buy. And closer to 1070, 1075, it's a sell. I mean, if you have the delivery. So, it's a trading stock at the moment. It's moving in a range. Here, I would like to say that, there are a lot of stocks which have just moved out of their trading ranges. I track MGL and IGL. They were moving sideways. Both are now trading above their, I think Chirag would know better. Both are moving above their trading ranges.
Okay.
These are the stocks to buy on declines, MGL and IGL.
Okay.
Like that, try and identify stocks which have broken out of their ranges. Kotak Bank has just broken out of a range. Those kind of stocks, RBL has broken out of a range. DCB, I think, is almost there. Karnataka Bank has completely broken out of a range. So, these are the stocks to buy on every decline.
All right. And you would also be looking closely into the stocks like Bandhan Bank and BHL. You have already said that now trading at about 0.7% higher at 69 rupees. And Bandhan Bank, like RBL Bank, are they still looking a good bet?
RBL Bank technically is a very good buy on declines. It sure is moving towards 670, 680. It's a slow mover. Bandhan is a long-term story. I do not track it so much. There are plenty of other banks like Karnataka Bank, Federal Bank, DCB Bank. They are much better plays in the mid-cap banking sector than Bandhan.
Okay. Which are the stocks, especially like HDFC Life or SBI Life? Which do you prefer in among the both?
HDFC Life at the moment. It hasn't moved. The market... all good stocks which have corrected and for whatever reason have not moved, identify those stocks, be patient, they will move.
Okay.
That's how the market is behaving.
So what do you feel Indigo currently is at? Would Ajayji, will it be a good price to book profit or stay hold, stay invested in Indigo?
I think if you have it, just hold it for some time and add on declines. It's a very good long-term story.
Okay, so where do you look in the next 6 months Indigo going to?
It all depends on the oil prices. I think oil should move higher. So Indigo will take a little time to, it will not run the way these Kotaks and Axis and these kind of banks are running, but it has run yesterday, it will take some time to cool off.
Okay, so viewers, now let's look into the mid-cap index gainers and losers. We are looking at the mid-cap stocks right now. Right now, this GMR Infra is the top gainer in the Nifty mid-cap. That's trading at about 17 rupees 25 paisa, by 1.5% higher. PNB was in this, you know, story, you know, because one of the main reasons was Mr. Nirav Modi, the fraudster businessman who was arrested in the UK on the 20th of March for, you know, getting the bank into a huge amount of about 11,000 crores of fraud done to the bank. And, you know, he has been put into the judicial custody up to the 29th of March. So I believe the stock is reacting positively onto that. The stock is gaining about 1.3%, trading at 94 rupees 70 paisa. There are more details, you know, yet to come in once the entire, you know, legal proceeding starts against Nirav Modi. So once the, you know, thing starts happening, we believe, you know, PNB may have some kind of, you know, good prospects in the coming days or maybe coming months together. Now let's look into the other stocks. We have other, you know, emails which were sent by our viewers. Chirag, when we look into the, you know, this mail, one Mr. Vishal sent this mail for Petronet and, you know, other two stocks, you know, being, you know, also being owned by them. Petronet was bought about 225 by one of the viewers. So what is your take on Petronet? Should that be, you know, a hold or sell?
Well, if you look at the overall chart structure of Petronet, it has been making cycles of higher top, higher bottoms, and it is witnessing some bit of selling pressure around levels of 248 to 249, and it has not been able to cross over those levels on a sustainable basis. Now, since he has bought it somewhere around 220-225, he's making somewhere around 8 to 10, 10 to 11 odd percent right now. So what I would recommend him to do is to place a trailing stop loss of around 7.5%, which comes to somewhere around say 240, and hold it with that stop loss for upside targets of say 255 to 260 over the next 10 to 12 trading sessions. If that level of 248 to 249 is crossed on a sustainable basis, then these targets are definitely going to come.
And we have another mail from Mr. Srinivas. That's the HDFC and Cipla, which they are holding since you know about 4 years around. But they didn't mention the price, what price they bought. But I'm sure they must be having good, decent returns, you know, received by HDFC, because they were also getting some good dividends. So will this stock be, you know, getting into a saturation mode? Can that be a sell or a hold, both the stocks, HDFC and Cipla?
Well, if he's bought somewhere around 4 years back, he is definitely making a lot of money right now. The stock is almost doubled as far as HDFC is concerned. HDFC, if you look at the overall chart structure of HDFC, it is very bullish. At least if you look at it in the short to medium term, the stock has been supporting the Nifty index in a big, big way. It has been responsible to pull the markets in a big way. And if you look at the, you know, the recent price action as far as HDFC is concerned, it is currently at a resistance of somewhere around 2010 to 2020. So if that zone is crossed on a closing basis today, if we see that the stock closes above that level today, then it is definitely moving towards say 2100 over the next 10 to 15 trading sessions. And this one, I would like to, you know, continue with the view that I was giving as far as the rollover stocks are concerned. You can look at rolling over your position in HDFC if it sustains above, you know, somewhere around 2020-2030 levels, at least for the next series.
Okay, we have Suresh from Ongole. He has bought a stock called NHPC and Hindustan Unilever, which has been correcting. I believe in Hindustan Unilever, he has bought around 1750, and you know, it's trading somewhere below 1700 right now. So what do you suggest?
Well, if you look at HUL, it is you know, witnessing a lot of selling pressure from higher levels. It made a high of recent high of somewhere around you know 1845, 1847, and it has been witnessing a sell-off from those levels, and it is currently trading around 1683.85. It has just given a breakdown of a distribution pattern, and we are expecting that the stock is likely to move towards 1650 over the next 4 to 5 trading sessions. So if there is an opportunity for the client to average, he can average at current levels, and the stop loss should be placed below 1650 for upside targets of only of a bounce back towards 1700, 1710. That is where he can exit the stock once.
Okay, there are some long built up, you know, open, you know, fresh interest coming, you know, coming into two stocks, that's M&M Finance and BHEL. What's your take on that, Chirag? Because especially M&M Finance has been, you know, not kind of a very big mover, but yes, it has been in tandem with the market movement. But is there any kind of fresh new highs can be looked into?
Well, yes, if you look at the overall chart structure of M&M Finance, it is looking, you know, pretty good on charts. And as far as a medium-term bet is concerned on M&M Financial Services, you can definitely go long around current levels. It has just witnessed a sell-off from higher levels, and it is currently trading around 423, 424 odd rupees. And you can go long with the stop loss placed below 414 for upside targets of 445 to 450 over the next 4 to 5 trading sessions, as I just mentioned.
Okay. So viewers, that's it for today. And right now, even the markets are trading higher by about 0.3%. Nifty 50 trading at 11,553, and currently the top gainer is again Bharti Airtel, and the stocks are, you know, trading in a positive zone. So, you know, trade with caution, trade with stop loss. So happy trading, guys. So let's see you again on the Monday morning at 9 a.m. Thank you very much for watching the show.